Tell us how it all began.
Yeah. So, good morning. It was, the week after, or pretty much the week of St. Patty's, and as usual, we'd start my week. I had came onto the floor, and we already knew that there was this new virus out that we didn't know much too much about. We were kind of treating it almost like a flu, but more infectious. And when I came onto the floor, I had a patient who was elder, who was having problems breathing, who I was very concerned about. So I kept gowning up, going into the room, seeing her. And a couple of days later, I just started not feeling well. And then I tested myself, and I came back positive. I was sick for about 10 days, and then by the 10th day, I was getting frustrated because I was still having fevers, I was still having trouble breathing, coughing a lot, and I was concerned because I was a new dad. My wife was also infected, so it was nerve-wracking, and we were seeing the cases kind of pouring into Plainview Hospital. So it gave me a unique perspective, but after finally breaking my fever, I was able to come back on the front line. And every week we'd get new information on, how to treat the virus, how to go about, stabilizing patients. But it was very frustrating because they just didn't seem to get better.
Everyone thinks doctors have all the answers and doctors don't feel fear, but you really did experience fear during that time. In your bio, you talk about worrying about your newborn daughter and your wife and what they would do without you, that at day 10, you thought, I may not make it.
Right, exactly. They went through my thoughts. Did I have my long-term disability? Did I have life insurance? Are they going to be okay? Simple things that people get to enjoy. Am I going to make it to her kindergarten graduation? Am I going to do the daddy-daughter dance? These were things that were going through my mind. As the person of the house, you think I'm responsible for them. So, what do I need to do if I'm not getting better? If I'm not going to make it to go through this, get through this. And it's scary. But at the same time, because usually when you have the cold or flu, you feel sick for a little bit, then you start to get better. This was just prolonged. This was more than a week. And I was just getting worse. So it was very scary, but thankfully, we made it through it. And then the following week, when I came back to work, my grandfather had gotten sick. And that was a new, kind of level that I had to wear a new hat was, because not only was I worried about him, but I brought him, over to our hospital, making sure that he got everything that he needed and get a fighting chance. We still knew that, unfortunately, due to all of his conditions, he wasn't going to have that much of a chance. And unfortunately, he did pass.
And he was very special to you, a real role model.
Yes, he
And that's a
was.
picture of your wife, who you were very concerned about as well, and keeping
Right.
everybody safe in your family. And you also lost your mother-in-law.
Yes, yeah. She's from Puerto Rico, and unfortunately, she also got the virus. She was doing well. We thought she was getting better, and then night to day, unfortunately, she also passed. It's especially hard on my wife, being a new time mom, and holidays being her favorite part of the holidays. And it's tough because you try to isolate yourself and tell people do everything you have to do, but even then it's still out there, and it just takes a couple of people to can infect you and make you susceptible.
Right, you lost 12 pounds during that time. I mean, you were very sick. This was not a
Yes.
joke for you. And as we discussed, you did not have any underlying issues that would have caused you to be this sick.
No, I'm very healthy. I like, working out, and I felt like I had strong lungs because I'm a trumpet player too. So, but it just was, it was very, I was very tired. I just kept coughing. At one point my oxygen level did go down to 87%. Sometimes knowing a little too much about medicine psychs you out as well. So
Yeah, sure.
I had to sometimes just calm myself down, say no, take a nice deep breath, take it slow, and then I, would slowly get better. But it was scary. It's something I definitely don't want to go through another time.
Yeah, you had a lot of the